We got to talk about what Chris Ballard said in his press conference because it's very fascinating. He went on to say at some point, we did not get to listen to all of it because we were live at the same exact time, but one quote out of the Chris Ballard press conference wrapping up this 2022 year that saw the Colts getting knocked out of the playoffs in Klondon.
Worst team in the league. Oh, no.
We embarrassed ourselves, we embarrassed our owner, and embarrassed our city. Okay, so I don't know if that is enough for all of Indianapolis to be like okay with everything that happened. But I do believe Colts fans are going to appreciate Chris Ballard at least acknowledging reality. Because I think in Hard Knocks last night with Frank Reich's speech, although I am a former player and I understand what he was trying to do to the team and to the relationships that they had and the trust and respect, a lot of the fans are like, this is bullshit, okay? Like, this is a little bit too nice. This is a little bit too kumbaya, especially for what just happened, especially when the thought all year was that there was going to be a Super Bowl run here. So I think Chris coming out today and saying a lot of things is going to change some people's minds on how we just ended serious right there.
Okay.
Nice.
Well, I tried to get a sentence completed. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But
good tease.
Good tease, yeah.
Hey. How what?
God.
Go to YouTube.
Damn it.
Go to YouTube.
It was a tease, dude. It was an absolute tease. But how they're viewing Chris and Frank, potentially. I'm not 100% sure. But as he continued to speak, and we don't know which came first or which came next, he also went on to address Carson Wentz. And Chris Ballard said, when he was talking about Carson Wentz, he said, at the time, we felt it was the right decision. I'm not going to make a comment on who is going to be here next year and who is not. He says there was good and bad from Wentz this past year. This comes from at KBowen1070, Kevin Bowen. Kevin Bowen used to work for the Colts. Now he works for 1070 The Fan down here in Indianapolis. Good dude, by the way, Kevin Bowen. Big fan. Guy. Big fan of this dude. You heard him on Hard Knocks all year because he and 1070 The Fan, his show, were basically a prominent part of telling the story how you go through there. Shouts to Kevin Bowen. He also allegedly told Siciliano that whenever he talked to Carson yesterday after the game, he told Carson, hey, you just got to make the layups, make the layups, make the layups. So this is a attitude towards Carson in the Colts that I don't think we've seen publicly for some time, but fans have been expecting and hoping for, because although they appreciated the good times that came with Carson Wentz, and there was a few.
Sure. Well,
this place is used to seeing some pretty elite level quarterbacking.
Oh, yeah.
So whenever Carson Wentz, you know, does his stuff, and listen, Carson's probably a great guy. I mean, he drives a Bobcat, so Ty's going to judge him forever.
Yeah, but he is a great guy.
But he is a great guy. Like, I think a lot of people in Indiana are like, hey, good guy, great guy. He lives his own life. He does things his own way, whatever the case. A lot of people probably hate him for some of the decisions he makes, whatever. I don't think this is about him as a person. But as a football player, I think a lot of people are very disappointed with how this Colts season ended. And there's... hey, it's probably this guy's fault if we had to get into it. And now that leads to the next question that Joe brought up yesterday whenever he called in. Who's calling the plays? Because then is it also their fault? And I think that's why Frank Reich has been so open about why he has made decisions, why he's done his thing. Everybody knows that they're being talked to. And I think with the way how they're being talked about, I think the way Chris Ballard talked today, just by reading the quotes, I'm going to assume that maybe Jim Irsay also had some, you know, some end of the year thoughts for Chris Ballard and Frank Reich. I paid Quentin. I paid Darius. I paid DeForest. But I paid Carson. I paid everybody, right? I literally, we had Hard Knocks in here.
Yeah.
We had almost an MVP, Defensive Player of the Year, Coach of the Year. Frank, you're up for Coach of the Year. We had this entire thing going and humming. I'm fully invested. I'm day to day here. I'm giving everything I possibly can. How the fuck does the team end up like this? I think Jim is right for probably asking some questions. I'm not 100% sure if he did, but it feels like the tone from Ballard was, hey, we got to answer some of this shit, which I appreciate. I want to let know I appreciate that, even though I haven't heard it at all yet.
Well, and we've said it 1,000 times, but like you look at that graphic, you can't have the NFL's leading rusher and two like generational talents on your line and just miss the playoffs. And I think part of it could be is you look at all the other stuff the Colts did this year with Irsay, like Peyton going into the Ring of Honor, Robert Mathis going into the Ring of Honor, Edge and Peyton going into the Hall of Fame, like kind of brings back those memories of like, hey, like
we, and Reggie's we, going in it, soon.
Exactly. Like you kind of have all this nostalgia around you of like, hey, we used to be one of the best teams in the NFL, and now we're getting beat by a division rival who's the worst team in the NFL and we're not making the playoffs. Like, that's just unacceptable.
And I think Jim Irsay and Peyton have become like actual friends and probably business partners if I had to guess, but national championship game, we were there, no big deal.
No big deal.
Sweet. But the suite we were above was Jim Irsay's suite, which was below us. And at one point, the sheriff came up, you know, and said, hey, how you doing? Mm-hmm. Good to see him. Good chatting with him. He talked to Jimmy Pitaro. Awesome. It was great to see the big guy. And he was going back down into Irsay's suite, and there's pictures of Peyton and his kid, Marshall, were in Jim's suite, you know, and that whole thing. I'd assume, you know, Jim and Peyton chatted about some stuff, about quarterback play and maybe even nostalgia about, hey, Peyton, you remember when you blah, 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 blah. And Peyton probably deflected it. But at the same time, Jim Irsay doing exactly what you're saying, like, we got a guy now who sprained both of his ankles on one play.
Mm-hmm.
This guy sprained his ankles on both of his ankles in one play. This guy. I mean, he's throwing, overthrowing people by 10 yards and things that are game deciding plays. It's like, although he is good and has made some good plays, we used to be the team. And I'm talking to this guy, Peyton, on a regular basis. It is fascinating. And I wonder if Hard Knocks was filming all that. That'd be sweet.
The comment from Ballard about at the time we thought it was a good decision or the right decision is basically like Jackie Moon saying, at the time I thought it was a good idea to wrestle Dewey the Bear in that cage.
Yeah. And at the time they needed a washer and dryer. Right. So we had to pull the trigger and get
corn dogs, Jackie.
Corn dogs for everybody in
here. Doesn't sound good for cars.
No. And then there's another quote, I guess, that just came through the text from Taylor Tannenbaum, who works for WT. WTHR, which is the local NBC affiliate, Channel 13. Shout out to everybody at WTHR. Colts GM Chris Ballard doesn't want to keep band-aiding the quarterback position. I'd like Carson Wentz to be the long-term answer, but sometimes it doesn't work out that way. It's been a QB carousel since Ballard arrived in Luck's retirement, and I don't know if that quote, okay, is necessarily his answer for Carson, or if he was explaining the entire situation about how Jacoby, we thought, was potentially going to be the long-term answer, and other people are there going to be a long-term answer, and maybe that's not directly about Carson, but none of these statements are like, hey, Carson's our guy, which is a conversation piece for the entire NFL, because they're going to go get a quarterback if they need one. In a place that you know well, which is Jim Irsay's building, obviously Chris came out today and he was talking about how we embarrassed our team, we embarrassed our owner, we embarrassed our city. They talked about, you know, wanting to have a quarterback in place, but it doesn't always work out that way. The future of Carson has not been locked in by Chris nor Frank. Do you think there's a chance that Jim Irsay is like, hey, what the fuck? And do you think there's any way that maybe one side of that could be like, ah, we have seven Pro Bowlers, our roster, and Chris looks at Frank like, hey, what the hell is going on down there? Because those two have been cemented together very well, it has appeared. Is there anything you think that could drive them apart, just like natural, hey, our livelihoods depend upon each other?
I don't think so. You know Jim as well as I know Jim. Upset, understatement, right? I mean, that was, none of us saw that coming, but devastating loss, because, you know, you start out the way they start out, and then you make this push and you're rolling and you win two huge games. You go to Arizona with absolutely nobody left on the roster and win there. And then, you know, the last 2 weeks of the season and culminating with the loss down in Jacksonville, you know, Jim, I know Jim, he's pounding that fist, you know, on top of that desk going, you know, what the F, how does this happen? You know, and, you know, you hear about the conversations that they had post game, a 2-hour meeting, whatnot. I'm sure it extended, you know, way past that, because you're going to get called in and you're going to, okay, where are we going? How does this happen, number one? And then how do we avoid this, you know, moving forward? You know, and then they start going through everything A to Z after, you know, probably take a few days off, a week maybe, then get back in there and say, okay, what's the plan, you know, moving forward? But I don't, you know, they both just signed, you know, 5-year extensions, I believe, at the beginning of this season or last season or whatnot. So both have done a phenomenal job. You got two really good football men in there. You got what seems to be a great relationship between a GM and a head coach, you know, which is obviously, again, very, very important to the success of that organization, that football team. And that's the owner's, that's his right, you know, is you know, you got to answer, you know, the tough questions. And I'm sure, you know, I know Jim, very, very well. And I know there were some tough questions there, and, you know, there's going to be tough questions moving forward, in particular your quarterback situation.